What is going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in this video, we're going to be talking about three ways to control your emotions when you're trading stocks. So whether or not you're a beginner trader, an advanced trader, an intermediate trader, you should know that emotions play a huge role when trading stocks. Human psychology plays a huge role when trading stocks as well. And it takes a while to really nail down your emotions and nail down your psychology when trading stocks. So in this video, I'm going to give you three things that I personally do when I trade stocks to really help, you know, control my emotions, because again, trading is an emotional, psychological game. You know, a lot of it deals with your emotions when buying, when selling, when adding more into your position, when, you know, cutting losses. It takes, you know, a bunch of discipline. And in this video, let's just talk about it. So the first thing that I personally do is scale into my positions. I talk about this a lot on this channel, and this really is the number one way that I personally control my emotions. And for those of you guys that don't know what scaling means, well, to put it into simple terms, if you have a goal position size of, let's say, $1,000, right? Scaling into that position would mean taking a 20, maybe a 15 or a 10% position at first, and then slowly adding more money into it as the stock or the ETF or whatever you're trading continues to go up in price. This way, guys, if you do this, right, initially, let's say that stock does go down in price, you wouldn't lose as much money as you would have if you were to go in all the way right off the bat with $1,000. And this is a great way to control your emotions and kind of keep yourself calm if it does end up going down in price initially. Because let's say, you know, you add in 10-15%, the whole idea of doing this is to potentially add another 10-15% if the stock or the ETF goes down in price a little bit more as well, and to add another 10-15% if the stock does end up going up in price from where you initially bought it. And it's a great way to mitigate your risk, guys, because again, you would not lose as much money with $100, $200 at first, 10-20%, you know, if it does go down, rather than if you went in with all $1,000 and, you know, it went down initially. So the number one way that I personally control my emotions is scaling into my positions and adding a little bit more if it goes down in price, and adding a little bit more, you know, even if it goes up in price. So the second way that I personally control my emotions is always having a plan in place when I'm trading stocks or ETFs. And this is something that's very obvious, especially to the intermediate and to the advanced traders, but beginners out there, a lot of them just hop in randomly in stocks with no plan in place. And this really messes with their emotions, right, guys? They hop in, it goes down a little bit, they don't know what to do, their psychology, their mind's playing tricks on them, their mind's telling them you should sell, you should buy. It's like a mind game, right? Their emotions are going crazy, you know, their heart's racing, whatever's going on, right, guys? And you know, it's the emotions are just going like this. So that is what I want you to avoid. The whole idea here, guys, is to have a plan to keep your emotions settled. Because if you have a plan in place, right, let's say I want to buy this stock at $10 and I want to add more at $10.25, I want to add even more at $10.75, and I want to cut my losses at $9.50, right? And I want to take my profits at $11. That's a very solid plan right there for whatever stock that may be. And that's something that you should be doing to control your emotions. Because let's say you hop in at $10, right? It goes up to $10.25. That means, okay, it's time to add more money. If all the technicals are pointing to that being the case, that would be a great way to, you know, approach that trade. So you add more money, and then it goes to 10.75, you add more money, and then you take your profits at 11. And on the flip side, right, let's say you get in at $10.25, it goes down to $10, right, then it goes down to 9.50, right, that's where you would cut your losses. And this is something that you went into that stock with the game plan, right? So this would really help you control your emotions, because you already have a game plan for that particular stock. You're not just hopping in it wildly. You're not just doing whatever the heck your brain is telling you to do. You know, you have a set game plan that is going to help you control your emotions and really just become, you know, a really, an organized trader. You know, you don't want to just hop in randomly, guys. This will really mess with your psyche, your emotions, everything. Trust me on that. So the third way to help control your emotions is just to simply trade with what you're willing to lose. And if you think about it this way, guys, you will not be as emotional as if you hopped into one stock with your entire account. So let's say you have $10,000 in your brokerage account, right? You know, if you're not willing to lose all that $10,000 or take a 5-10% hit on that $10,000, because realistically, you're not going to really lose that entire $10,000 unless you're really unlucky, unless you really don't have a plan in place. But let's say you do not want to lose that whole $10,000, right? What you would want to do is maybe trade with only $2,000 and then implement that rule of scaling and implement that rule of, you know, having a plan in place before trading. And this would really help you control your emotions when trading, because think about it, guys. Let's say you only have $10,000 in your Fidelity account, in your Robinhood, in your TD Ameritrade, in your E-Trade, whatever you guys trade with. You're going to be super, super emotional and attached to that money if you go in all in with $10,000 on a position. I promise you guys, it's going to drive you absolutely crazy if you do this. So that is why that's the third rule, is to just trade what you're willing to lose a decent amount on, right? You're obviously not going to lose the entire $2,000 or $10,000 or $15,000 if you're trading, right? That's not going to happen unless you're trading a very scammy penny stock, or, you know, a high-flying weed stock or something like that. You're most likely only going to lose 5-10% at most if you did not set a stop loss, or 2-3% if you do set a stop loss. So rule number three, guys, tip number three, please, please, please plan on just trading what you're willing to lose 2-10% on, let's say, if you do not set a stop loss, or 2-3% if you do set a stop loss, which you all should be setting stop losses, because that is a very important thing to do to really just control how much money you do lose, because you will lose money when trading stocks. It's inevitable. There's no way in heck you're not going to lose money. So always set a stop loss and always just trade what you're willing to lose about 2-10% on, in my personal opinion. So the number one rule, guys, scale into your positions. Number two rule, always have a plan in place, stop loss, where you're taking profits, where you're adding more money, where you're selling out, all these different things. And rule number three is to always trade what you're willing to lose at least 2-3% on, and maybe 5-10% on the absolute worst case scenario. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, follow me on Twitter, join the Discord group chat, as well as the Facebook group. All of those are linked down below in the description box. I'll catch you guys in the video later on today talking about the trading and market update. I'll see you guys then. Have a great day. Peace out.